Alright. So today, I'm gonna start with Mega Man 5, which starts out with a little cutscene of the kind of the setup for this game, which is a little bit different than the last games. Because you remember Mega Man 3 was heavy on Proto Man, and then Proto Man didn't really show up hardly at all in Mega Man 4. And now Mega Man 5 starts out, Proto Man comes up, and he abducts Dr. Light, which is the first time that Dr. Light's life has seriously been in danger. So, you're on a mission to destroy all the robots that apparently Proto Man has under his alliance. And then once you do that, you can find a way to Proto Man's castle and stop him and rescue Dr. Light. So, a little bit different from the previous Mega Mans, you know. They're all about Wily coming out, and he's jealous, and he's just kind of waving his cock around, and you have to go and slap him on the wrist. And it's a little bit different, or at least it seems like a little bit different. I'm sure you know how this turns out, but if you don't, it'll be a pleasant surprise. And so a lot of people like to shit on this Mega Man, because it's not as good as the last ones, like Mega Man 3, Mega Man 2, or whatever. But certainly, I feel this game is a lot better than Mega Man 4. Which is why I'm playing it and not Mega Man 4. It takes a lot of the stuff Mega Man 4 did. It kind of refines it a bit. I mean, maybe the weapons aren't as cool in this game as they were in the last game. But that's okay, hardly ever use them. Which is, you know, that's one of the things we don't like about Mega Man 4 and Mega Man 5 is the special weapons aren't really as useful as they used to be. Because your Buster is just so much stronger than it used to be, so you kind of don't even really need him anymore. So, one of the things that makes this Mega Man kind of cool is it adds a couple of new elements that are kind of interesting that hadn't been used before. Which maybe you're noticing is, you know, expressed very well, or most prominently in this stage, Gravity Man stage. Which is new gravity elements. And they don't come into play very much anywhere else in the game. I think, I don't know. I don't even know if they come into play at all at any other part in the game. I don't remember. But it's kind of a cool idea. But that's the thing about Mega Man. Is Mega Man's always been pretty cool about they'll introduce an element that maybe is super awesome. But no matter, like, despite the awesome elements and the not-so-awesome elements, pretty much nothing in the game is repeated more than once. So, I mean, that's one of the things why this game is so short, but it's also why the games are so good. Is that you, like, if you wanted to, you could take an entire decade's worth of Mega Man games, Mega Man 1 through Mega Man 6, and they all seem the same on the surface. They're all pretty basic. But you put them all together, and you got, like, you know, 8 hours worth of entertainment, you know, and that's if you're really good at it. But hardly anything you will see in any of the Mega Man games, like to talk about the games, or critics like to say the games are repetitive, you know, they just kind of grow stale after a while. It's like, well, if you dissected every element, you know, because most of Mega Man is like just a bunch of little single screen obstacle courses, right? If you dissected it to that and looked at all the Mega Man games, then you probably wouldn't find a scenario that's repeated more than maybe once. Like, or at least not the same types of tropes. It's very dynamic. You know, maybe the same kind of element will be the basis of a stage, it'll be kind of a theme. But beyond that, you don't see the same thing more than once or twice. Like, you know, like, you could look at pretty much a lot of stuff. Like, this little elevator. This elevator pops up later in the stage, and that's pretty much it. And you never see it again. In fact, I don't think I've ever seen the elevator like that in any other Mega Man games, except for a couple of times in the Mega Man X games. Now, here's one of the things that kind of makes, these games, I don't know if it makes it harder, or makes it easier, or less, or more frustrating. But the fact that, like, you see all these flying guys that I've been dealing with. And usually, I would, you know, like, in other Mega Man games, you just, you know, you just shoot them a couple of times and they'd be dead. But they don't die with a couple of shots. It takes a lot of shots. But you can just kill them with one charge shot instead. So, I don't know the fact that they had to make them, if they made them deliberately harder, so that, you know, you couldn't just kill them in a couple of shots, as you had to charge up a shot. You know, creating an excuse to, you know, have the charge shot in the first place. Or whether it makes it harder because you actually have to put more effort into killing them. I don't know. I'm still kind of debating it. I think it makes it unnecessarily cheap, but that's just me. I think it would be better off with the older system where you didn't have a charge shot, but most of the little enemies died in just like 3 bullets, you know? I really like the design of that guy. The giant, he almost kind of looks like Gravity Man, except really big, and obviously not as tough, because he dies in only a couple of hits. Oops, some high skill jump there. So I didn't even know you could do that at first. I thought you always just had to commit suicide to grab that that A. But, apparently not. Figured out how to do it. So, like, you know, this little elevator stage right here, I've never seen anything like this in any of the other instances of Mega Man, except for, like once or twice in the Mega Man X series. Which is good, because it's kind of annoying and stupid. I mean, fuck that part. You know. If I'm gonna die on this stage, that's probably where it's gonna be. Nothing else in this stage is really that perilous. Which is, I guess one of the things that, you know, maybe people like or don't like about this game as much as other games, is that this game is clearly the most easy Mega Man game of all the Mega Man games. If you took it compared to just all the Mega Man games, it's way easier than all of them, in pretty much every way. However, the bosses are, you know, they're easy, and they're pretty predictable, but they don't become crippled when you use the special weapon against him. So I applaud that initiative, at least. Because, like you just saw there, I killed him in like a few seconds, but it's not like he was frozen in place, just waiting to die. He was still attacking me. He just wasn't attacking me very well, because I knew what he was gonna do, and he didn't do very much. So, where am I going now? I'm gonna go to Crystal Man stage, right? And, because he's weak against the gyros. And the gyros are pretty awesome. One of the better items that you ever seen is in these series. And once again, I'm not sure if this is a good thing or a bad thing. I think it's kind of a good thing. Most of the items that you, special weapons you get in this game, aren't all that useful. They're mostly situational. They're not like straight upgrades to regular attacks, you know, like as you'd expect from other Mega Man weapons, like the Metal Blades, the infamous Metal Blades. But I kind of like it because, like, you know, you can only use it in certain situations that it's actually very useful for. And then beyond that, you know, just stick to your guns, you know? It's almost kind of like a Castlevania kind of thing, where you wouldn't normally use, just, you know, rely on your special weapon. You just, you know, go out and fucking use your whip until you have a situation that is really impractical. So, this stage is pretty easy, pretty straightforward, but the only thing that bothers me that makes this stage really hard for me is these parts right here with the crystal dispensers, because they have really weird patterns, and I usually get hit a couple of times and die before I can pass them. So let's see if I can get through this perilous obstacle. There's a very brief pause, but it's not consistent. It changes with every one of the dispensers, and I hate it. But luckily that element doesn't really return. I don't think that ever pops up again, which is good. Just fuck that. Seriously. I mean, it's kind of weird. Like, I kind of say that this game is really easy, and I kind of complain about it. Because, you know, I like, my favorite ones are the ones that are more hard, but I mean, seriously, the only things that, and then I complain mostly about the things in this game that are the actual really hard parts, but, you know, Then again, I'm not a fan of cheap deaths. I don't think anyone is. So, most of the things that are really hard are just really cheap deaths. Like what's coming up right here, where you die instantly from spikes. And if you're not in just the right spot, at just the right velocity, you will not be able to get that V. And you will have to do the whole stage all over again. Because at the bottom of that level, at the bottom of that pit, is a checkpoint, I believe. Is it a checkpoint? I think it is a checkpoint. I don't remember. I'm pretty sure it's a checkpoint. So, you'll have to do the whole stage over again if you want to get that V. Which, of course, you want to get the V. Because you know what the V unlocks, don't you? It unlocks just the coolest new ability for Mega Man. Which, by the way, that is the introduction of Beat in this Mega Man game. He hadn't appeared before that. They were thinking about putting him in the game before this. But it is where they finally got around to doing it. So like I was saying about like the bosses. Like you saw, he died pretty quickly from the gyros, but he was still coming at me really hard. And if I wasn't good at dodging, and he, you know, was better at aiming, then he would have probably could have killed me, came close to it. That is one of the things that kind of mystifies me, is you see this little get weapon screen. It's the little animation and the whole cutscene is very kind of cheap. There's not a lot of flash to it. And Mega Man 3 wasn't very flashy. It just had like a little artwork still. Mega Man 4 had like a full animation going. And it was probably the most expensive thing of that game, it seemed like. It was astounding. But in this game, it's really, really cheap. It's just Mega Man, the normal Mega Man decal, twirling around in place. So like the only expensive part of this game is the little cutscene you see at the beginning, and I don't even think there's a cutscene at the end. There's a little cutscene at the end. That's it. The rest of this game was like all, you know, in the regular engine. Which is okay, it's not that bad, but it's something that kind of bothers me a bit. Like, you know, they could have put more into it than just that little crappy get weapon animation cutscene. Because other Mega Mans have put more effort into it, they put more flash into it. Just saying. Here's some more of them lovely water physics, where you can hardly move. And here's where, like, these weapons are kind of useless. It took, like, almost an entire clip of that move to kill that one guy flying the helicopter. And guess what? Here's another one. So, yeah, not the most useful repertoire, but luckily he flies off into a different dimension and I don't have to find him anymore. Otherwise, I have to bring out the gyros. He's a cool little mini boss. I love the animation, the design of this guy. To me, he looks like a giant ape kind of guy, but like he almost kind of has like a evil cyber Santa kind of look to him, as well, future Santa. Anybody knows what the fuck that is? You need to fight two in a row. Yeah, I got an N. I wonder what that stands for. So now, get this extra life that I clearly am not going to need, because I'm probably not going to die in this game. Because like I said, it's really easy. As long as you don't fuck up and get instantly killed by something cheap, then this game isn't really that hard. Some of the bosses are kind of tough, but you got plenty of E-tanks, you can tough it out. Because like, you remember when I was playing Mega Man 3, and I had like a ton of E-tanks? And like I had like max E-tanks for most of the game. Which by the way, here's another one of those cheap instances where if you don't know these guys are coming, that's another instant death. And you can't kill those guys, by the way. That's where I'm at shooting them. It's most of the time guys pop out of holes, you shoot them once, they die. No. You can sit there, you can wail on them for 10 minutes with all your weapons. You will not kill one of them. They're indestructible. So I'm fighting Napalm Man. Which is a really awesome name for a boss, but I think he looks pretty stupid. Because he has like the little like tank treads for feet. which I don't really get, and he's shooting like, I don't know, I'm not sure what those bombs are supposed to be. They look really weird to me. I've never seen bombs shaped like that. So I don't know. I don't know what's going on. It was a fun stage though. Especially like the lions are kind of cool. And future Santa looking guy was pretty cool. Here's another one of them cheap little get weapon animations. Which I like that color scheme for him, for Mega Man, with the blue, or I guess it's lavender, and the orange. Looks pretty neat. That napalm bomb is